Hi everybody. I would like to know how many people did not speak Bahasa? Raise hand. Did not speak Bahasa. So I think everybody speak Bahasa Indonesia, but the host told me speak English is mandatory, so it's difficult. I have been 5 years didn't speak English. How about the audience? Who can understand when Indonesian speak English? Raise the hand. Only 2-3 audience who can understand when Indonesian speak English. You can understand? Raise your hand. Okay, quite good. I need to ensure that you understand when many people speak English here, you can understand what this mean. I will tell you a story. I will tell you a trick. If there are 4 people with 4 nationality, first Japanese, second South Korea, the third Taiwanese. Okay, they hold this is from Asia, and then Indonesia. We can know what their nationality after having fart. Somebody know what is fart? Kentut. I thought it bilingual. Jadi kita bisa mengetahui 4 orang ini kebangsaannya setelah mereka kentut. Bagaimana caranya? The Japanese usually say after have the fart, pardon me. The South Korean people usually say sorry me. The Taiwan said usually excuse me. But the Indonesian people said not me, not me. Okay, let's just I want to ensure that you listen this one. I don't want to talk longer about the history because you find this information in the internet. Okay, this one is all guys who actually officially mean that we decided to go to as a legal organization before the law in Indonesia. Why we feel this is important? Because in Indonesia, so many community, Ubuntu community, OpenSUSE community, in the open source and Linux distro-based community is so many. And then another university also, they have their own community. But for the community who under the umbrella of university, that is safe for them. But what the community that established themselves, we cannot say this is not legal. But actually this is illegal. Because if you are not have the legal document, you cannot have the right or participate on the any of government activity. And let's say that you will have some event like this. You cannot ask the permission. So it is why the legality considering is important. But can we live without legality? Of course. We can live without this legality. So these people, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, decided to establish legal document before the law and is completed. Mean that the Ubuntu ID has an office, has a geographical address. This is we know in Indonesia as domicili. We have a tax number, tax identity, and so on. But these people, including me, we do like a doctor. We do like a doctor. We have kid. We have children. After this birth, then we forgot. We forgot everything. Everybody abandoned this one. Everybody busy with his own. So actually, we have to act like a parent. It is a difference between doctor and parent. As a parent, you have kid. You have to educate him or her. You have to ensure your kid healthy. You have to ensure that they have good education. You have to ensure they grow well and probably have something in the future. You have to ensure everything safe. But this not happen. This not happen with this Ubuntu ID. So in this very, I call this is amazing opportunity, because actually I have I retired already. I didn't have any relation directly with this community before I live in Jakarta, and then I relocate to the jungle. So I hacked the nature. I didn't hack the computer anymore. I built a biodigester. I built a hydro power plant in the jungle. Because at the time in the 2017, I live in the one village. And this is shocking me. In the Java Island, there is no electrical supply. Still, for me, this is shocking that a village in Java Island still have no electricity supply. Mean from the state on it electrical company, PLN. So, I think at that time I thought, how we do talking about the computer? How we will think about the software? When even no electricity. That's life. And that village also, and all of you here, most of the students, the highest education there is junior high school. The senior high school is far away. You have to go for about 16 kilometers. That is a very bad road, so you can only walk or use motorcycle. If the parent have to send their kids to senior high school. They have to prepare the motorcycle, then this is expensive for them. So when I come to this room, many students in the university, many friends, I saw this room full of the electrical equipment. That's very nice. Because almost 5 years I didn't see that one. So I living there, I built the small hydro power electricity, only have lightning. We cannot use rice cooker. We cannot use refrigerator. This only lightning. We can use bore machine, okay. Because my skill, my knowledge in electricity is not enough. I bought the electric motor from China, 7 and 10 kilowatt, can running. The electricity is up, but not working very well. Okay, back to this. I think I wish to offer, especially to the young here, how about and you make a group, 2, 3, 10 people to take over this one. To take over. But most a problem of the organization is how to run community organization, company, whatever. You have problem how to run. Maybe some the young here is scary if you have organization that don't know how to run. What is the most scary for this one? Cost, expenses. Even this is a non-profit organization, but for how to run this one, you need still the expense. So how you get this expense? The way if we asking fund or donation or whatever, it is not easy. It is a very tough work. In our discussion or online discussion, probably with some friend of here, we are thinking that we run this community because this is legal, like a corporation. This is what we as a community, what we have done, this is a history, is over already. At that time, we have a team build a distro, this is GPLE, and then the Ubuntu ID took over the Blangkon project under the situation that at that time, Blangkon is Red Hat Beast, then we change to Ubuntu Beast. But now Blangkon is an independent project. They have been rise up, become the son of Ubuntu ID, and now they are. Okay. Actually, this community is not. We also involved at that time. The open source movement have a very very attractive attention. The government push have their own project to spread out everybody in Indonesia, government, everything, to use as much as possible the open source software. So we help Kota Pekalongan to fully migrate from the proprietary software to use open source software. Of course not 100%, but most of them they are doing this migration. So as a community, if you have a legal standing, legal document, legal body, you can officially involve like a consultant, like advisor, whatever, and this get paid. The government willing to pay this one for sure, because of you involved in this government office, you have to adhere, you have to follow, you have strictly follow all the requirement. You have to have manage the taxation, you have to issue the invoice, you have a good management, you have to follow the beauty contest, everything. But in fact, that open source community have sufficient human resource. If you run this one, it's very easy. If you have problem, you have obstacle, you have some difficult, oh, I cannot do this one, you can ask help. Many people can help. So this is a way, one of that, if this community you manage properly, they can run like a corporation. But so what is different? The legal body of Ubuntu ID, the legal form of Ubuntu ID is perkumpulan. This is not a foundation. This is perkumpulan. What is different between perkumpulan and corporation or foundation? The very easy imagining is foundation or corporation is like a kingdom. Like a kingdom. Of course they have some assembly to elect the chairperson, everything, but perkumpulan is mandatory. The chairperson have to be elect on the general assembly. This is mandatory. So we choose the legal body as perkumpulan to accommodate the spirit of democracy. It is why, because we need a good response from the young FUAs. You make a group of people, 5-10%, then we can discuss. You can contact the host how to do it, and then we do it after this event to make this what we have done in the past time is history ready. What we have ever tried to empowering small business, we assist the government office and many things, is we can make this still on stage We can continue this. And I believe manage the community can be your career. Why not? Can be your career. Now today I think the sarjana degree, if you have passed this education, it also not easy to find a job. It's a less group to make their own business, also not easy. So if you wish, if you have spirit, you have willing, you can gather with some people and decided to take over this legal community, you can make this your career. What you need, you can tell the to the senior, I think everybody here is still alive. Still alive. Still alive. Everybody is it true? Still alive, right? Pak Hidup, okay. So because Pak Hidup, we can contact them. You can contact them. This can do whatever you think, but you cannot take alone. It's only 1% you cannot do, because this is perkumpulan. The spirit of perkumpulan that you are working on group. Working on group is only advantage of a human being, only advantage. I have a research. I read a research. I was born in 1964, so I was a baby boom generation. Today call is millennial, Gen X, millennial, and Gen Z. Okay. According to the research, individually, baby boom generation have higher IQ than millennial. In general, this research measure average IQ of this generation in Indonesia. My generation have about 81.2. The IQ, 81.2 average, but the millennial have lower IQ, 76 something. Can we believe this research? Is it correct that the older people individually has higher IQ than the young? That research is correct. But why? The millennial and Gen Z live better, have better life, have better knowledge, have better clothes, have better education. Why? The lower individual IQ show the result of better achievement from the individual higher IQ. So what is the phenomenon? What is this? According to the expert, and I agree with this, that our intelligence get lower individually,
Sorry, Mr. Hadi. Maybe the presentation could be faster because the time has run out.
Okay. Thank you. It means that what increase if collective intelligence? Our collective IQ is increased. So this means that when we doing together, we doing in group is will be better when we do individually. Okay? Because the time is over. When this offer is interesting for you, you can contact the host. You can contact the host and the team will help you. I think there is no answer and question.
Yeah, because the time has run out. Maybe if anyone have a question, you can ask directly to Mr. Hadi in outside the session.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hadi. Thank you, Mr. Hadi. You can come back to your seat.